Thanks for joining us here on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham. The city that brought you bans on large sugary drinks and trans fats is now the home of the first public elementary school with an all-vegetarian cafeteria. It is taking a healthier school lunch to a whole new level. But how do the kids feel about tofu wraps and vegetarian chili? You've probably heard about Mayor Michael Bloomberg's soda crackdown in the Big Apple.
I think they did go too far because people should be allowed to drink and eat what they want to drink.
Asking the government to protect us from large Cokes, I think, goes beyond what the government should do.
But now, a lunch menu for the history books.
Whether through the vegetarian diet here or other type of menu options that we have in our schools, it all involves healthy eating.
Public School 244 in Queens, New York has been experimenting with all-veggie meals since earlier this year. Now, it's 5 days a week.
This menu here in the school, I would have to say, is definitely in the vanguard of one of the options that we want to offer kids.
PS 244 has more than 400 students. They're in pre-kindergarten through third grade. School officials say before they begin the full vegetarian menu, students actually gravitated towards vegetarian items.
It makes me nutritious and want to tell my family, which makes me be more nutritious.
It's very healthy and it makes your body strong.
Meanwhile, PETA couldn't be more pleased. One employee stating, quote, "We think this is a really exciting development." But when a reporter asked the kids if they like the new lunches, a less than enthusiastic response. And critics worry. Children who eat an all-vegetarian diet may not get the protein they need. Some health food advocates say they're not worried.
Actually, most people in this country get 2 to 3 times more than they need, and plant-based proteins are actually very healthy. They have no cholesterol, and they're low in total fat and saturated fat, and they're high in fiber.
PS 244 is a zone neighborhood school, so students who prefer meat aren't able to transfer out. And children who prefer to eat vegetarian can't transfer in either. Young teenage girls can now buy emergency contraception pills straight from the shelf. The morning after pill, also known as Plan B, will now be available to girls as young as 15. The Food and Drug Administration announced Tuesday the drug will be placed on store shelves instead of behind the pharmacy counter. Before the change, girls had to be 17 and had to ask a pharmacist or doctor for it. Social conservatives oppose the move, arguing parents and medical professionals should be involved in major medical decisions involving young girls. Republican Congressman Paul Ryan says he believes gay couples should be able to adopt. According to a USA Today article, Ryan said he has recently changed his views on the issue. Back in 1999, he voted in favor of banning same-sex couples from adopting in the District of Columbia. Today, he says he would vote differently. Ryan went on to clarify he still believes marriage is between one man and one woman. Human trafficking is on the rise in Louisville, Kentucky this week. The reason? The Kentucky Derby. Criminals try to take advantage of big events like this as many potential customers come to town seeking prostitutes. Mark Martin has more.
The Kentucky Derby is known as the greatest 2 minutes in sports, and for many it evokes the sounds of hoofbeats and my old Kentucky home. To human traffickers, the city and its famous horse race are simply avenues for exploitation.
We have high rates. We have a serious problem.
These pimps, our handlers, look at it as a way of making fast money in a one-day or two-day event, and they're going to double and triple what they normally make. So they'll bring these girls in from all over.
Louisville Metro Police and victims' rights groups monitor websites known for adult escort advertising. They estimate postings on these sites for Louisville have tripled this week leading up to the Kentucky Derby.
And before Keeneland Spring Meet and before the Derby, women and what we believe to be our children are advertised as fillies and mustangs.
Sergeant Andre Bottoms says the prostitution human trafficking rings are set up in hotels in every part of the Kentucky-Indiana area surrounding Louisville. Bottoms estimates about 10% of the hundreds of prostitutes in Louisville this week are being forced or coerced. After each prostitution arrest, police look for signs of trafficking.
Then we change course, and at that point we treat them as a victim and not a criminal.
Teresa Flores is a survivor of human trafficking. She founded the organization Traffic Free, which helps build awareness through what's called the SOAP Outreach. SOAP stands for Save Our Adolescents from Prostitution. At national events like the Kentucky Derby, the outreach program distributes thousands of bars of soap to high-risk motels in the area. The soap is wrapped with a red band that gives the National Human Trafficking Hotline number and asks questions like, are you being forced to do anything you do not want to do? Mark Martin, CBN News.
The National Human Trafficking Hotline number is 1-888-373-7888. Volunteers offer the soap free of charge to motel owners and explain what is happening to young girls in their motels. A Philadelphia jury is now weighing murder charges in the trial of abortionist Kermit Gosnell. Silence by the media and the White House has prompted congressional Republicans to take action. Meanwhile, a new undercover video by a pro-life group reveals that at one Washington, D.C. clinic, babies who survive an abortion are left to die. Dale Hurd has the story.
Prosecutors say Kermit Gosnell routinely cut live babies in the back of the neck to sever their spines. Pro-abortion groups have made Gosnell's alleged murder of live children look like an aberration in the abortion industry. But a new undercover video shows a Washington, D.C. abortion doctor telling a 24 weeks pregnant woman he will not give medical care to a baby born alive. This video, released by the pro-life group Live Action, shows a conversation between their investigator and Dr. Cesar Santangelo. Listen to what Dr. Santangelo tells the investigator he would do if the baby survived the procedure.
Technically, you know, legally, we would be obligated to help it, you know, to survive. But, you know, it probably wouldn't. It's all in how vigorously you do things to help a fetus survive at this point. We would not help it, let's say. We wouldn't intubate.
And fresh investigations of abortion clinics in the wake of the Gosnell trial have led to the closures by state officials of a clinic in Ohio and three clinics in Maryland. In Delaware, two nurses quit an abortion clinic, with one saying, "I couldn't tell you how ridiculously unsafe it was." Troubled by the lack of media coverage in the Gosnell trial, 72 members of Congress have sent a letter to the three networks asking them to report it. And they blasted President Obama for his silence.
Mr. President, your silence on this issue is deafening.
The mainstream media has all but gone silent and failed to cover this horrific violence against women.
I think we all recognize if Dr. Gosnell used an AK-47 instead of a scalpel, the media coverage would rival a natural disaster.
President Obama, a vocal supporter of Planned Parenthood, has said he can't comment on the Gosnell case while it's still underway. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
So, just how common is the practice of letting late-term abortion survivors die? Live Action's Lila Rose came on CBN's Newswatch to tell us more.
As many as 1 in 10 children after a 23-week abortion survive the abortion attempt. So the big question is, what does the abortion industry, these abortionists who are being paid up to $10,000 each, what do they do with the survivors of these abortions? And our investigation indicates that there's this corporate knowledge in the abortion industry that they take victims of abortion and they leave them to die, or they put them in jars of toxic solution, these little babies. I mean, in the Bronx clinic we released, the worker saying that they put the baby, if it's still moving, after 24 weeks, a fully formed baby in a jar of toxic solution so that it'll suffocate to death. I mean, this is just, it'll drown. This is just the tip of the iceberg for what's happening in this industry and what we're beginning to release to the public.
You can see Lila's entire interview at our website, cbnnews.com. A U.S. government panel that tracks religious freedom says China, Saudi Arabia, North Korea, and Iran are among the world's worst violators. The U.S. Commission on International Religious Freedom advises the U.S. State Department. Commission Chair Lento Sweat says some of the worst persecution occurs where it's illegal to change religions or commit blasphemy. Muslims who convert to Christianity can face the death penalty in Iran. In Pakistan, blaspheming the Islamic prophet Muhammad can also bring a death sentence. Investigators are uncovering new clues about what may have inspired the older Boston bombing suspect. They say Tamerlan Tsarnaev traveled to a notorious mosque in Dagestan last year, where he met Chechen terror recruiter Ansar Nadal. Russian authorities killed Nadal last year. Here in the U.S., investigators also continue their search for possible accomplices. They've identified nearly a dozen persons of interest, including Tamerlan's widow.
We want to leave no stone unturned. We want to see, is there in fact additional protocols and procedures that could be put in place? And we won't know that until that review is completed.
Investigators say Tamerlan also had internet contact with William Plotnikov, a Canadian boxer who moved to Russia and joined a terror group. He was also killed in a raid by Russian authorities. Coming up, it's the slogan stamped on T-shirts and bumper stickers, coexist. But for one expert, it's easier said than done. Find out why next.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 US gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? And this first basket is what my $20 bill buys: milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy: 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
Help!
If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh. Yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my medical alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my medical alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a medical alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than a dollar a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free medical alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
From CBN.
Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum, you and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute.
Superbook.
No.
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen. Plus, 2 copies to share with others. All for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah. Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him! He is alive!
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
An atheist group is urging the Pentagon to block officers from sharing their faith with subordinates. Mickey Weinstein of the Military Religious Freedom Foundation recently met with high military officials. He says even a Christian bumper sticker on an officer's car or a Bible on a desk can amount to, quote, pushing the fundamentalist version of Christianity on helpless subordinates. Weinstein said officers who do that should face a court-martial. The Chaplain Alliance for Religious Liberty says restrictions on religious practice will discriminate against evangelicals. Reverend Ron Cruz is asking for equal time to share his concerns with Pentagon officials. We hear talk about tolerance and peaceful coexistence among religions and cultures, and it sounds good, but is it really possible? Author Robert Stern says he doesn't think so, and he recently spoke with CBN's Chris Mitchell about it. But first, here's a quick look at the popular notion of mutual coexistence.
There's a popular symbol on bumper stickers and t-shirts that spells out the word coexist, using the symbols of the world's dominant religions and cultural groups. Its purpose is to promote tolerance and peaceful coexistence. But author Robert Stern says the reality is that coexistence is a myth. Instead, a war for world domination is raging. In his book, No We Can't, Radical Islam, Militant Secularism, and the Myth of Coexistence, Stearns explains why these warring worldviews will lead to a critical tipping point in global culture with potentially devastating consequences.
Robert, thanks for being here on Jerusalem Dateline.
Good to see you, Chris.
What is the myth of coexistence?
Well, you know, I think of Winston Churchill, who said, an appeaser is one who keeps feeding an alligator, hoping that the alligator will eat mm-hmm. him last.
Right.
60 years after a madman in Europe stood up and said that he wanted to control the whole world and millions upon millions were killed, we have to understand that in an age of suicide bombers, at an age of nuclear capability, when we have extremist elements who are dedicated to the destruction of the Western mm-hmm. civilization, the Western way of life, we need to take these people seriously.
And do you think in some ways they're trying to reshape Western civilization, something that we really need to be aware of?
I see within the radicalized portions of Islam an extremist view of Sharia law, that they are, let's remember, not only trying to impose upon the West, but trying to impose upon more moderate Muslim countries. Mm-hmm. We look at Turkey, for example. Turkey was at one point a very modern, moderate Muslim society, right. And yet now we see the increase of Sharia law in nations like Turkey, Egypt, and all of the unrest that's going on there. So we have to be aware of this global imposition of Sharia that is the goal of a radicalized version of Islam.
I remember Bernard Lewis says they're a menace to their own people before they're a peril to us, talking about the moderate Muslims. What about militant secularism? How does that fit into current day?
Well, we see among certain societies, we can look at Europe, we can look at other places where we've lost the Judeo-Christian foundations that have framed Western civilization. And we've tried to say that all cultures are equal and all cultures deserve the same hearing. Well, when you lose the immune defense system that a mm-hmm. Judeo-Christian worldview brings to a society, and you begin to then redefine what freedoms are and what truth is, you then lose the ability to speak out on the kind of encroachment that a radicalized Islam would bring. And so we see this happening increasingly in Europe, where the increasing tide of Islam is unable to be stemmed because Europe has forgot their Judeo-Christian worldview. Mm-hmm.
And for more of Chris's interview with Robert Stearns, go to our website at cbnnews.com. Up next, Ireland is one of the safest places in the world for a pregnant woman and her baby, but that could soon change.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans. with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Ireland is one of the safest countries in the world for a woman to have a baby, but that could soon change because of an intense political battle over abortion. Dale Hurd has the story now from Dublin.
35,000 Irish citizens converged on Dublin in January to tell the government to leave Ireland's pro-life law alone. Ireland is one of the last safe nations in Europe for unborn children, but that could all change soon. Ireland's abortion restrictions have come under intense international pressure and relentless attacks in the Irish media, and now some are blaming Ireland's pro-life law for the death of a pregnant woman. Ireland's media and pro-abortion groups have been pushing a story that a 31-year-old pregnant Indian woman died because she couldn't have an abortion. But the facts of the case are misleading. Nia Vivrian is a national pro-life leader.
When news of Savita's death first broke, it was massively exploited by abortion campaigners. This became a global headline. And the global headline was that Ireland had killed Savita Halappanavar because of our pro-life laws.
Savita Halappanavar died last year at University Hospital in Galway from septicemia, or blood poisoning. Her husband claims they requested an abortion three different times in hopes of saving her life. The press reporting made it sound like she died because she couldn't have an abortion. But at the inquest into her death last week, medical experts determined that Savita died from sepsis and a series of medical errors, termed a medical misadventure. But the media continues to make it look like she died because she was denied an abortion. Dr. Sean O'Donnell is a psychiatrist and an Irish pro-life leader.
The Irish media basically went to the world media and said, look at Ireland, Catholic Ireland, it's allowing people to die because they can't have abortions.
Pro-abortion groups want the government to make law what Ireland's Supreme Court ruled in something called the X case that would allow abortion if the mother felt suicidal. But experts think that would lead to de facto abortion on demand. Sinead Ahern is with the pro-abortion group Choice Ireland.
Every day that the government fails to act to legislate for the X case is another day that women's rights are being violated and women are potentially being placed at risk.
The message that women's lives are in danger because of Ireland's abortion law appears to be exactly wrong. The statistics show Ireland is one of the safest places in the world for a pregnant woman.
Irish doctors are not prevented from intervening where there's a life-threatening condition arising in pregnancy, that they will always intervene to save the mother's life, even if that means the unintended death of the baby. We can say in this country, we have banned abortion for 30 years. In that time, we have become one of the safest places in the world for a mother to have a baby, and that's according to the United Nations.
Irish Prime Minister Enda Kenny was elected on the promise that he would not open the door to abortion, but he's already wavering. Pro-life protesters in January called for Kenny to keep his promise. But the Irish Parliament is said to be formulating legislation that would allow abortion if the mother is suicidal. Even though a majority of the Irish people are pro-life, the odds are now stacked heavily against the nation's pro-life law.
The most pro-life country, perhaps in the whole Western world, is now standing on the brink of abortion.
The European Union has been pressuring the country to change the law. And pro-life leaders say they're being outspent by millions of dollars. Compared with that kind of firepower, pro-life forces can only take their message to the streets and try to win one heart at a time. But the forces arrayed against Ireland's abortion law are very strong.
The pro-life movement is fighting back hard. We cannot make this the year that abortion is legalized in Ireland and our pro-life ethos is destroyed forever.
Dale Hurd, CBN News, Dublin.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip.
Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. Then it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window, yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Some Christians are taking a bold stand for their faith by reading the entire Bible out loud on the steps of the U.S. Capitol. It's part of the 24th annual Bible Reading Marathon, and even the rainy weather in Washington, D.C. couldn't stop the Word of God from going forth.
Oh Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praises.
We're here reading through the entire Bible. We start on the Sunday prior to the National Day of Prayer.
For every beast of the forest is mine, and the cattle on a thousand hills.
And for 90 consecutive hours, we read through the entire Bible. It's important because the Word of God is important. It's the foundation of our belief, and it's the foundation of all the laws that this country holds so dear.
There is none who does good, no, not one.
I think it's pretty awesome. I'm not necessarily a religious person, but I am a spiritual person. I think it's amazing that they're out here, and they're willing to do this.
Hear my prayer, O God. Give ear to the words of my mouth.
I have a daughter who's almost four, and so I've been really thinking about returning to church. I grew up Christian, so I've been thinking about returning to church for her. So yeah, I definitely would pick up a Bible and start to read again, you know, because of this.
We feel like we're Nehemiah reading the Bible publicly. We want people to read it devotionally, but it's very important to read it publicly. The rain's coming down, our glasses are fogged up, and we're peeling the pages back and trying to hold them down. But we keep reading.
Give ear to my prayer, O God.
Word come alive. Well, that is going to do it for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com. And take the time to tell us what you think about the stories you've seen here today. You can do that on Facebook or at CBN News on Twitter. Hope you'll join us again right here next time. Have a great day.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free no-obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com.
Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. The CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.